been given a slightly curious brief, and I promised myself I would not try to speak to you in jargon. I know that you love jargon, you people. I don't quite understand your language, so I have to be very careful what I say. But I wanted to talk to you, particularly, I think, about with modern science and modern advances in modern research, the very serious need that is often lacking and very important, which is the issue, I think, of how we engage the public with the advances that are being made, not only in healthcare, but in science generally. And I think, to some extent, we should see the sciences as no longer isolated between chemistry, physics, biology, and mathematics, but much more integrated than they were. Certainly, when I was a student, medical research was totally different and would be seen as something which would be purely funded by the Medical Research Council. I now sit on a research council, but I don't sit on the Medical Research Council. I'm on the Engineering and Physical Sciences Research Council, although I'm not an engineer and I know not a great deal about the physical sciences. But the point, I think, is interesting that, of course, research councils like the EPSRC do a huge amount of work which is absolutely relevant to healthcare. And I suppose one of the issues to consider is the changing vista. So what happens, for example, with electronics is going to be much more likely to be involved with healthcare than it was hitherto, and there will be new dimensions, for example, in the fields of mathematical modeling, which will be relative to healthcare as well. And one of the issues, I think, is that I think we have something of a crisis in our hands in understanding how the research that we do as scientists and the research that you sometimes market and how industry uses is actually relevant to the population in general. And I thought it would be interesting to consider a few exemplars and explain where I think we've not actually been particularly good. And one can start anywhere, really, in the whole field of science. The issue actually really is where the public engagement has been successful rather than where it's been unsuccessful. The lack of success is actually much commoner. And so I've listed here just a few which occurred to me as I was coming to speak to you earlier today. And if you look at the crisis that there's been in British science, you could argue that one of the first real watershed crises was in the issue of genetically modified crops. Now, there is no question that 15 years after the initial discussions of genetically modified crops, and now I know that I'm involved with genetic modification myself, but I'm not talking about my subject. I'm not talking about genetically modified animals, which is a completely different area. But in the field of crops, it was very obvious that we got things crashingly wrong. I think it's very clear, 15 years on, with the increasing awareness of climate change and global warming, that although genetically modified crops will not solve the world's food and water problems, they could make a very big impact. It's worth bearing in mind that in Africa, for example, one third of the population has a starvation subsistence, bare subsistence diet. And we can now modify crops in this country so successfully that they're both drought resistant, so they can take much less water and use much less water, and also at the same time, they are able to resist viruses. It's extraordinary to think that something like 20 to 25% of the world's output of cereals is destroyed by pests in many parts of the third world, not obviously in this country. But the attack on things that we would regard as staple diets is really quite extraordinary from the environment in which they are placed. And so the idea of searching for crops which might be resistant would be extremely valuable. Now, the issue turns out that, for example, in this country, we can't even do that research, even though I would argue that in plant biology, we've probably got the most sophisticated molecular genetics anywhere in the world, including the United States of America. And the reason why we can't do that, of course, is because we can't do field trials. And the reason why we can't do field trials, of course, is because when they've been done, the trials have been destroyed and there's been very little support from government to continue that. And in fact, indeed, even now, government is still somewhat reluctant to consider how that might be done.